Good morning.
Morning.
For those of you who have the time to be with us this morning, we will continue our SMG Word, Scripture Message from God, and our online Bible study or our Bible encounter. Yung pong mga may kailangan gawin, you may go and ikain nyo na lang kami ng breakfast. To our online parishioners who are staying with us, today we reflect on John, the Gospel of John. Pero hindi natin kukunin yung buong aklat ni Juan for the meantime. Let us first focus on one chapter. Because for the next 5 Sundays, we will be focusing on John chapter 6. So the next time I'll talk about the Gospel of John in general, but today we focus on John chapter 6, a very important chapter in our, at least, faith in the Eucharist, especially in the real presence. So you have your Bible with you. For those of you who are at home, you may join us. We focus on one very long chapter, verse 1 to 71. Imagine that, no? Ganun kahaba yung John chapter 6. So this Sunday, we will begin to navigate. Every Sunday thereafter, for the next 5 weeks, we will read from John chapter 6. Are you there yet? And it begins with the feeding of the 5,000, our gospel this Sunday. And then Jesus walks on the sea, the miracle of calming the storm, and then the bread of life discourse, which begins from verse 22 and following. And after that, the ending, which is the conversation between Jesus and Peter about the words of eternal life. So we focus on John chapter 6. For the past how many Sundays, we were focusing on Mark, at least on our Sunday readings. Pero strange, because we will have a little break from Mark, and we will insert 5 weeks of John, and then we go back to Mark. Yan. So kung nakikita po ninyo yung inyo pong calendar, yung kalendaryo ninyo, yung Bible diary ninyo, yan, may break. Ba't kaya merong 5 linggo? Ang sagot po ay because John chapter 6 is the discourse about the Eucharist. Para maintindihan natin ang kahalagahan ng Eucharistia sa ating buhay Kristiyano. Sinimulan ni Juan ang paglalahad ng turo sa Eucharistia sa pamamagitan ng pagpaparami ng tinapay. Jesus feeds the 5,000. Magandang pagnilayan ito muna. Of course, I will develop this tomorrow. But I think you're very much familiar with the story of the multiplication of loaves. Now, the people, the crowd, they were hungry. They were in a place that is isolated. And Jesus went up into the hills and he sat down and he saw so many people coming to him. And Jesus said to Philip, "How are we to buy bread so that these people may eat?" So many of them. "How are we to buy bread so that these people may eat?" So ang tanong ni Jesus, very practical. Hindi niya tinanong muna kung may pera ba tayo dyan. Hindi niya tinanong kung may natatabi ba tayo dyan. Hindi niya tinanong kung may mga baon ba kayo. Ang unang tanong ay, paano natin pakakainin? We are given a window into the mindset or attitude of Jesus. Jesus, when he looks at people, He does not look at them in terms of what is lacking or what is problematic. When He looks at people, it's always to help them, to show compassion to them, to have mercy on them. So when He saw the crowds, He asked Philip, how are we to buy bread? So ang tanong po, bakit si Philip ang tinanong ni Jesus? Ang sagot po ay, dahil si Felipe ay taga ron sa area na yon. Philip comes from Bethsaida together with the brothers, James and John and Peter and Andrew. So they came from Bethsaida. The site of the multiplication of loaves is very much near their place. So bakit si Felipe ang tinanong ni Jesus? Kasi familiar siya sa lugar. Tinatanong ni Jesus sa kanyang alagad na si Felipe, how are we to buy bread? Saan tayo pwedeng bumili ng tinapay? Pero ano po ang sagot ni Felipe? Philip answered him, 200 denarii would not be enough bread. You would not be not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little. Simple lang agad, no? Ang tinatanong ni Jesus kay Felipe ay, saan tayo bibili ng tinapay? Ang sagot ni Felipe ay, wala tayong perang pambili. Hindi, ang tinatanong ni Jesus, saan tayo pwedeng bumili? How can we buy bread? And where can we buy bread? But the answer of Philip is, we don't have money. Because Jesus knew what He was going to do. At yun ang sabi din ni San Juan sa atin. Jesus knew what He was going to do. Alam niya kung ano ang kanyang gagawin. Another disciple, Andrew. Ito, magkakapitbahay lang ito. Sina Andrew, Peter, Philip, they come from Bethsaida. So, Andrew was a little more resourceful. Ang sabi niya kay Jesus, Lord, we have a boy here who have 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But Andrew right away again also answered Jesus, but how good are these for so many? What are they among so many? Yan. So si Felipe tsaka si Andres, pareho ng mindset. Si Jesus, ang tanong ay, saan tayo pwedeng bumili? He's looking for a store to buy food. Pero ang pag-iisip ni Felipe at Andres ay, we don't have money and we only have little bread. A few bread and fish. Ano yung pagkakaiba na yon? Pagkakaiba ng pag-iisip ng Diyos, the God of abundance, and the mindset of the people, the mindset of a small mind, lacking faith and trust in what God can do. Sabi po ng ating ebanghelyo, nung pinaupo ni Jesus ang mga tao, He asked them to sit down. And there was much grass in the place. So the men sat down. He took the loaves. He gave thanks. He distributed them to those who were seated. So also the fish as they wanted. And when they had eaten their fill, He said to them, gather up the fragments left over. And He gathered them up and filled 12 baskets. Yeah. Prefiguration of the Eucharist, the Eucharistic gestures. Ano po ang unang ginawa ni Jesus? Pinaupo ang mga tao. Sa banal na misa, umuupo tayo. We sit down together. It's very important that we sit down together. Hindi po tayo magandang kumakain habang naglalakad. Hindi po maganda na tayo po ay magkukwentuhan. O, pwede rin magkwentuhan, pero ang sinabi ni Jesus sa kanyang mga alagad, paupuin sila. importante po yung pag-upo. Sige nga, upuan natin yan. Kasi ano yung ibig sabihin ng pag-upo? Aside from being organized, it is also a sign of spending time with each other. Spending time in meals and in conversation with one another. So, pinaupo ni Jesus sa mga tao, and then He took the bread, He gave thanks. Kinuha ang tinapay, nagpasalamat, hinati at binigay sa mga tao. The miracle of the multiplication of loaves. There are some scholars who are saying na the miracle that happened really in this is the sharing of people's bread. That's one way of looking at it. Kaya naman naparami ang tinapay dahil daw po lahat ng mga tao nilabas ang baon nila at binigay sa kanilang katabi. That could be possible. But many Bible scholars are saying, no, it was a real miracle of the multiplication of loaves. It was Jesus who made, you know, who multiplied the loaves and distributed them for everyone to partake. At meron pang sumobrang 12 bakol ng tinapay. So John chapter 6 begins with the miracle of the multiplication of loaves, with the instruction of Jesus to sit down and then taking the bread, blessing the bread, breaking it and distributing to everyone. What are these gestures? They call this the Eucharistic gestures. So after that, the people wanted to come to Jesus and make Him the king, kasi believe na believe sila sa ginawa ni Jesus. So when the people saw the sign which He had done, they said, "Indeed, this is the prophet who is to come into the world." Perceiving then that they were about to come and take Him by force to make Him king, Jesus withdrew again to the hills by Himself. So si Jesus ay, nung nakita niyang nagtatangka ang mga tao na iluklok siyang hari at siya ay gawing pinuno, He avoided confusion and chaos. So He went again to isolation. He went up the hills by Himself. So this is the first part of John chapter 6, the multiplication. The second part of the chapter, Jesus walks on the sea. Nung maggabi na, si Jesus ay bumaba doon sa bundok, nakita niya ang kanyang mga alagad na ang kanilang bangka ay malapit ng lumubog, and Jesus went to them. It was now dark. The sea rose because a strong wind was blowing. And when they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea, and they were frightened. But He said to them, "It is I, do not be afraid." Then they were glad to take Him into the boat, and immediately the boat was at the land to which they were going. So Jesus, another miracle, walking on water. Malakas ang hangin, binabayo ang bangka. Pero si Jesus ay naglalakad sa tubig, kinalma ang dagat, at siya'y sumakay sa bangka. The second part of John chapter 6. Anong ibig sabihin nito in connection with the first? So if the first is connected with food, sabi po ng mga dalubhasa, si Jesus, ang unang himalang ginawa niya ay John chapter 2. At ano ang nangyari sa John chapter 2? Yung pagbabago ng tubig at naging alak. At ang sumunod niyang himala ay connected with food, ang pagpaparami ng tinapay. So kumpleto na ang kanyang liturgical tools. Changing of water into wine and multiplication of bread. And now we add up, Jesus walks on the sea. In other words, John is trying to portray to us that Jesus is God. He is the Son of God that can command the sea. He is God who can walk on the sea. He is God who can multiply the bread. He is God who can change water into wine. He is God who can heal the sick. He is God who can give sight to the blind. There is power in Him. So there's nothing impossible for Jesus because He is a God. That is what John wanted to portray about Jesus, especially in John chapter 6. He wants to tell us that God is capable of providing for us. God is capable of calming the storm of our lives. Jesus is in the boat with us. Even if it is dark, He will lead us to the other side, our destination. If we are hungry, He will provide food for us. So John chapter 6, first two parts pa lang, binibigay na sa atin ang katotohanan na ang Diyos ay makapangyayari. Kaya huwag kang mag-iisip na ikaw ay mawawalan o mauubusan. Kaya huwag kang mag-iisip na ikaw ay magugutom o ikaw ay maiiwanan. Jesus provides. God provides. Pakasabi nga sa katabi natin yon, God provides. Natatakot ka na ba dahil kulang ang pera? Yun ang pag-iisip. Yun ang pag-iisip ni Felipe at ni Andres. Wala tayong pera pambili ng pagkain. Dami-dami niyan, 5,000 mahigit yan. Paano natin pakakainin silang lahat? Ang sabi ni Jesus sa kanila, hindi ko tinatanong kung may pera tayo, wala. Ang tinatanong ko, saan tayo bibili? At minsan, kapareho tayo ni Felipe at ni Andres ang pera. Pero ang sinasabi niyang Panginoon sa iyo, meron. At meron yan. Amen? Meron yan. Huwag masyado matakot. God provides. So this is the whole theme of John chapter 6. God provides. Third part of John chapter 6, that tinatawag po nila itong the bread from heaven or the bread of life discourse. So on the next day, the people who remained on the other side of the sea saw that there had been only one boat there and that Jesus had not entered the boat with His disciples, but that His disciples had gone away alone. So nakita ng mga tao na ang umalis ay yung mga alagad, hindi si Jesus. However, boats from Tiberias came near the place where they ate the bread after the Lord had given thanks. Again, very important. Near the place where they ate the bread after the Lord had given thanks. To give thanks. So, the gesture. He took the bread and He gave thanks. This is familiar among the Jews because they do this oftentimes in the Passover meal. They call it Seder. In the Passover meal, it's always the meal of giving thanks. Kaya ang tawag po natin sa banal na misa ay Eucharistia, kasi ang ibig sabihin ng Eucharistia, Eupharesto, ay pagpapasalamat. Eucharistia means thanksgiving. So, when the people saw that Jesus was not there, nor His disciples, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum seeking Jesus. And when they found Him on the other side of the sea, they said to Him, Rabbi, when did you come here? This is already in Capernaum. Jesus answered them, Truly, truly, I say to you, you seek me not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Yan. Ngayon, binibigyan na sila ni Jesus ng pagpapaalaala na, oh, nabusog kayo sa napakaraming tinapay na sumobra pa. Pero bakit nyo ko hinahanap? Sinundan ng mga tao si Jesus. inalam kung nasaan yung bangka ni Jesus. Yeah. Nakita po ninyo yung detalye na yon, kung paanong ang mga tao ay nung matapos silang mabusog ni Jesus, hindi na nila tinantanan si Jesus. Kahit na siya'y umakyat ng bundok, kahit na tumawid ng dagat, hanap sila ng hanap, pamilyar sila kung ano ang bangka na sinasakyan ni Jesus. Hinahanap nila si Jesus. They kept on looking for Jesus. And one way to locate Jesus is to know where His boat is. Isang magandang larawan din po ito, mga kapatid, kasi ang simbahan po, ang larawan niya ay bangka. The bark of Peter, bangka ni Pedro. That is also our imagery of the church. Early Christianity was associated with ichthus, the fish, and early church was associated with the bark of Peter, ang bangka. So, pamilyar sa mga tao ang bangka ni Jesus. At kaninong bangka ang ginagamit niya? Madalas ang bangka ni Pedro at ng iba pang mga alagad o kung sino man ang mahiraman niya. The ship, the boat, is the church. And in the boat is Jesus who is with us, who multiplies bread and loaves for us. Parang ako po dito sa parokya natin, no? May mga parishioner po tayo, kabisado na nila yung aking sasakyan. Alam nila kung saan nakapark, no? Kaya, naku, wala si Father, wala yung sasakyan. Kaya minsan ho, sinasadya ko talaga iwan yung sasakyan, tapos nagbumotor ako para di nila alam na sa totoo po, nandyan lang ako. Yan. So minsan, no, ang dami sa atin ay naghahanap kay Jesus. At yung mga tao din naghahanap kay Jesus. Ang sabi ni Jesus sa kanila, bakit niyo ako hinahanap? Dahil lang kayo ay nabusog? Yan. At doon na sinimulan ni Jesus ang kanyang bread of life discourse. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give to you. For on Him has God the Father set His seal. Then they said to Him, what must we do to be doing the works of God? And Jesus answered them, this is the work of God, that you believe in Him whom He has sent. So they said to Him, then what sign do you do that we may see and believe you? What work do you perform? Our fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, He gave them bread from heaven to eat. And Jesus then said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. And they said to him, Lord, give us this bread always. So John chapter 6, tungkol sa tinapay. Nagsimula sa physical na tinapay, ngayon ang usapan napunta na sa tinapay na galing sa langit. Tinapay na pinaulan ng Diyos nang nagugutom ang mga Israelita sa disyerto. Tinapay na nagmula sa langit. At tinapay ng buhay na walang hanggan. Ang sabi ng mga tao kay Jesus, Lord, give us this bread always. So kita po natin yung progression of the conversation from the physical bread to the bread of life. And Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall not hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. But I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and him who comes to me I will not cast out. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of Him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that He has given me, but raise it up at the last day. For it is the will of my Father that everyone who sees the Son and believes in Him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up the last day. Now Jesus is expanding the conversation. Bread from heaven, and I am the bread that came down from heaven. I am the bread of life, and I will give you eternal life, so that you will not look for physical food anymore, but you find in me the bread that leads you to life. But people did not want to believe him. The Jews murmured at him because he said, I am the bread which came down from heaven. They said, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How does he now say, I have come down from heaven? The beginning of the doubt and skepticism of the people. Now they are murmuring. Kita po ninyo yung sudden shift in John chapter 6. Tuwan-tuwa sila, pinakain ni Jesus. Pero ngayon, nung sabi ni Jesus na hindi lang physical na tinapay ang ibibigay ko sa inyo, ibibigay ko sa inyo ang tinapay ng buhay, at ako ang tinapay na ito. Doon na nagsimula ang... Teka muna, something wrong, parang hindi yata tama yung sinasabi mo. Ano yan, niloloko mo ba kami? Anong sinasabi mong ikaw ang tinapay ng buhay at ikaw ang tinapay na galing sa langit? And Jesus said to them, do not murmur among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except him who is from God. He has seen the Father. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Nako, unti-unti nang naguguluhan ang mga Hudyo. Ulitin ko yung kwento. Nagsimula sa tinapay na kinain, nabusog, may sobra pa. Hinanap nila si Jesus, natagpuan, may bandang Kapernaum. Pero ang sabi ni Jesus sa kanila, huwag niyo kong hanapin dahil nabusog ang inyong sikmura. Magtiwala kayo sa akin kasi ako'y tinapay na galing sa langit. Akong tinapay na makapagbibigay sa inyo ng buhay na walang hanggan. At ako'y galing sa Ama at dadalhin ko rin kayo sa Kanya. I came from the Father. Ayan, so medyo nag-aano na sila. Parang, oops, teka muna. Anong pinagsasabi nito? Parang sumusobra ka na. Ayan. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread which comes down from heaven, that a man may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread which I shall give for the life of the world is my flesh. Nako, naloko na. Dinagdagan pa ni Jesus. Tinapay na galing sa langit, sinugo ng Ama, tinapay na nagbibigay ng buhay na walang hanggan, at ang tinapay na ito ay ang aking katawan. Sabi ng mga Hudyo, the Jews disputed among themselves, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Yan, doon na po nagsimula. How can this man give us his flesh to eat? So they could not understand what Jesus was talking about. What are we? Cannibals? We will eat your flesh. And if we do that, what do you make of us? Fools? Yeah. So Jesus said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he who eats me will live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not such as the fathers ate and died. He who eats this bread will live forever. Hindi po maganda ang pagkakabasa ko ng passage na to, pero I would like you to watch in YouTube yung pagkakabasa ni Jonathan Rumi, yung pong actor ng The Chosen. He read this in the National Eucharistic Congress in the US. You look it up in the YouTube. You can do it even right now. When he read this passage, nangingilabot ako. Ang husay ng mamang ito, no? He is the, mas pogi pa sa akin, no? So mas maganda siyang sa kanya po, no? Pag are you there yet? Mamaya po, tingnan niyo po sa YouTube. Jonathan Rumi, National Eucharistic Congress. And it will appear there yung kanyang sharing. Alam niyo po, si Jonathan Rumi ay siya po yung actor playing the role of Jesus in the series The Chosen. And he is a devout Catholic. At nung nagsasalita po siya, yung kanyang t-shirt, siyempre, machong-macho, no? Pero naka-t-shirt siya. At nakalagay doon sa kanyang t-shirt, ang statement sa kanyang t-shirt ay, if it is not real food, to hell with it. Or, if it is not the body of Christ, to hell with it. He is a firm believer that the Eucharist is the real presence of Jesus. The Eucharist is not symbolic. It is really Jesus. And the Jews disputed with Jesus. That's just stupidity. What you're telling us, hindi katanggap-tanggap yan. Yan, so mga kapatid, no? Ito yung pagninilayan natin for the next 5 weeks. Yung binasa ko po ngayon, ito po yung 5 weeks na pagninilayan natin. And what is the main point of John chapter 6? That Jesus offers himself to us as the bread of life, as the bread that gives eternal life, and this bread is his flesh. Last part, and I would like to end with this. Many of his disciples, when they heard it, said, "This is a hard saying. Who can listen to it?" But Jesus, knowing in himself that his disciples murmured at it, said to them, "Do you take offense at this? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is of no avail. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But there are some of you that do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who those were that did not believe and who it was that would betray him. And he said, "This is why I told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." After this, many of his disciples drew back and no longer walked with him. Painful for Jesus. Again, nung nagsimula ang John chapter 6, thousands of people flocking to Jesus because they were fed. They were given bread and fish. But when Jesus shifted the conversation into a spiritual bread that is his flesh, the people began to be disappointed and even ridiculed Jesus, and they began to go away. They could not accept what Jesus was saying about his body as real food. Jesus said to the 12, "Will you also go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God." Yeah. So John chapter 6, limang linggo nating, so ito pong pinaliwanag ko, limang linggo nating bubunuin po ito. Kaya meron na kayong overview ngayon ng 5 Sundays na ating pagninilayan ang John chapter 6. And what is at the heart of John chapter 6? Jesus as the bread of life. That we are provided by God. Do not worry about the physical bread. God will provide. But always look for the bread that can sustain your life, your spirit, your faith. Look for that bread. Ang tinapay na ito na matatagpuan natin saan? Sa Eucharistia. Kaya po yung banal na misa is the heart of our Christian faith, the summit in front of our Christian life, because this is the legacy of Jesus bequeathed to us, given to us, not just as a memorial and as a reminder of his words, but also of his real presence. He is giving us his body, blood, soul, and divinity every time we partake of the Eucharist. This is not just a symbol. This is not just a remembering of a past event. No. Every time we break bread on the altar, every time the priest confects the Eucharist by the power of the Holy Spirit, and the priest would say, "This is my body. This is my blood." It is not the priest saying these words. It is Jesus once again giving us himself as our real food, as our true drink. We believe that he is present even today, that he is alive because of the Eucharist, that he is physically and materially present among us, because every time we sit down, we break bread, every time we give thanks, every time we distribute the bread, which is the body of the Lord, we are nourished time and again by Jesus himself. And let us not miss that, the Eucharist. So natutuwa po ako sa ating lahat na mayroong devotion to the Eucharist every day. Sa mga online parishioners din natin, every day kasama natin. But our suggestion is, every Sunday, come to the Eucharist. Yung sa weekday, we can say na pwede na yung ating online mass. Yes, we can go as far as allowing you to stay online during the weekday masses. But if you can come physically to the church, even on weekdays, better. But Sunday, let us never miss our Sunday Mass, because it is where Jesus would like to physically, materially offer the bread, which is his flesh, which is his body to us. His body, blood, soul, and divinity. It is where the Lord encounters us in the most intimate way possible. Because once we take the bread that is Jesus, once we receive the body of Christ, he becomes us and we become his. Once the elements and particles of the bread are broken down into smaller bits and pieces, and they become part of our blood, distributed to every organ of our body, the body of Christ sanctifies us, nourishes us from within. That's how powerful the Eucharist is. That's how important the Holy Mass is. The Holy Spirit changes the bread and wine into the body and blood of the Lord. On whose command? not my command, not the command of the Pope or the bishops, no, in at whose command we celebrate the Eucharist, Jesus. And it begins with John chapter 6. Later, at the Last Supper, Jesus will repeat the same gestures. He will take the bread, he will give thanks, he will break the bread, he will distribute the bread. Same actions in the Last Supper, same actions in the Mass. Taking, blessing, breaking, and sharing. And the challenge to all of us is how to make our lives Eucharistic as well. That our lives are always taken by the Lord in surrender and trust in His providence. Our life is blessed by the Lord. We are blessed. You and I, we are blessed. Don't be like Philip and Andrew who are thinking of their inadequacies, of the lack of material resources. We are blessed all the time. And Jesus blesses us so that we can be a blessing to others as well. That's the Eucharistic miracle. We multiply ourselves in love and charity. Amen? Ayan, so mahaba na po ito at ako po ay meron pang isang recollection na pupuntahan naman sa Paranaque. But for now, I invite you, dear friends, go to Mass, go to Mass. Jesus is waiting for you. And an assignment, kahit ngayon po, gawin niyo na, watch Jonathan Rumi. And listen to how he delivers John chapter 6. I tell you, mai-inlove kayo sa kanya. Ako nga ngayon, crush ko na siya. Sabi ko, ang husay naman ng mamang ito, no? Paano ko kaya magagaya ito, no? Ang husay, kasi higit pa sa mga pare, nung binasa niya ang John chapter 6, parang ayoko nang basahin. Kasi parang gusto ko, pwede ba ikaw na lang, tol, ikaw na lang, bro, ang magbasa nito. Kasi hindi ko kaya. Pero ang sabi niya, every time he prepares for a scene in The Chosen, he's saying he prays because he plays the part of Jesus and he talks to Jesus and he tells Jesus, use me as your instrument. And I think that's the message of the Eucharist. Jesus becomes body and blood. His flesh is given so that we can embody him in our life. We become alter Christus, another Jesus. We embody His flesh to be shared with all around us. Amen. Maraming salamat sa inyong pakikinig. God bless you all. Thank you.